love when I saw her yesterday. It's who she's thinking of, and she told me what to say. She said she loves you.
Like a lot of teenagers in Liverpool, you know, when the rock and roll or EG, you know, folk scene or skiffle, whatever it was, and the records getting started playing on the radio, you know, I was captivated by the music, the sounds that were coming out, and I suppose that culminated and came to real fruition when my mother opened the Casbah, you know, in 59, even though the music scene had been on long before that. I mean, Liverpool was always a hotbed for music, you know, even before, you know, the 50s, you know, then even the 40s, big band, jazz, you name it, it came from Liverpool.
I was in, like a lot of teenagers, to people like Cliff Richard, Johnny Layton, Mike Sarn, Mark Winter, Elvis Presley, and of course, great Liverpoolian was Billy Fury, Ronald Wycherley. And it was sort of lovely music, but certainly the British acts tended to be what I would call very middle of the road.
Like most kids in Liverpool, started off on a guitar. I wasn't comfy with it, right? It was just like, yeah, fine, did the usual three chords, and like, nah, I'm not getting the hang of this, too good. Drumming, I was banging pots, tables, this, that, and the other, right? That's my scene, that, you know, so watching old movies with Gene Krupa on, became captivated being drums, and then actually seeing drums getting paid in the cellar by different bands from Liverpool. When the opportunity came to actually form a band, it was like, I want to be the drummer. Or they would turn around and say, you are going to be the drummer. And that's how I got involved. You know, started off with a little band called the Blackjacks, which played the Casbah and the local scene. And then, of course, the rest is history in a way.